Fair warning. This is gonna be weirder than usual. Can't be helped. You called me. So here I am. I know I shut you out sometimes. I'm always glad to hear from you. It's just that I get my hopes up. So many times it's led to nothing. I found nothing. It's like we live in a room and there's a poster on the wall. We stare at it and we think that's the whole world. The room and the poster. The picture's something nice. A landscape, a famous person. Like in that movie, what is it called? The prison movie. The room's a cell, and the picture, it's different. For each of us, it can be beautiful or terrible, but we're all transfixed. But it's all a lie, something to distract us from the truth. They're lying to us. We're lying to ourselves. The room's not the world. The world is much bigger and much stranger. There's a hole hidden behind that poster that leads to the real world. We all feel safe in that room. But sometimes something crawls out from behind the poster. And the ones that see it happen freak out and try to forget what they saw. I'm here. Why did you bring me here?
Hello? Anyone here?
this seal. I saw it a long time ago. I keep seeing it in my dreams. Federal Bureau of Control. All these years, I've been looking for them, and they were hiding in plain sight.
Hello? Hey, excuse me.
There you are. You are here about the job. Janitor's assistant. You need to go to the interview. Go that way to the elevator.
Thanks. Elevator that way. Got it.
Very good. I'm Ahti, the janitor, by the way. You'll work for me. You can say I sent you. If they don't hire you, then you're no relevant. Help me work for the axe. Take them behind the sauna, you want.
I've done enough night shift loner jobs to know it makes us come off weird. Ahti the janitor is a friendly face in my book.
Better than somebody with no face at all. Think about it. No face.
But that said, I know what you're thinking. If there's an axe murderer around, that's him. The cell and the poster. I was 11 years old the first time I saw behind the poster. They told me I imagined it. I've been trying to pull it down ever since. Will you help? Did I lose you there for a moment? You know what's on my mind. My baby brother, Dylan. 17 years since the men of this bureau took him. Shit. You want me to pick it up? The murder weapon? Really? And there goes the poster.
Objects of power can cause or be results of AWE's altered world events, intrusions upon the perceived reality. Now, the service weapon is, of course, a prime example of an OOP, a very powerful one. Ingrained in the Bureau's DNA, a key component in our prime candidate program. Come out of that Russian roulette a winner and you, you're it.
Look at this place. Where am I? The same gun. Okay, now I have a gun.
the Bureau safe.
Did you hear that? It's the dead man. Right after the pyramid spoke to me, and it was just noise, and I understood every word. And this gun's alive. You know what? I'm happy. Happy to be here. Things have quieted down outside. Is it safe to go?
Objects of power can cause or be results of AWE's altered world events, intrusions upon the perceived reality. A side note, remember to cover their connection to the astral plane as well. Now, the service weapon is, of course, a pro.
Mine, says the dead man. Okay. hissing sound that tried to invade me earlier. The hiss, burrowing into everything in this place.
Is the hiss your enemy? All right, it's our enemy.
That babble's contagious. It burrows in like an infuriating melody that makes you hum it over and over. Hissing sound that tried to invade me earlier. The hiss, burrowing into everything in this place.
Is the hiss your enemy? All right, it's our enemy.
That babble's contagious. It burrows in like an infuriating melody that makes you hum it over and over.
Thank you.
cleanse the control point. What does that mean? Help me fix it.
To me. We saw you deal with the compromised agents. Is it safe to come out?
I can't tell you how happy I am to talk to somebody sane.
The feeling's mutual. Yeah, I'm Pope, Emily Pope, Dr. Darling's assistant.
My turn. Should I lie?
Jesse Faden. I'm just visiting.
I should have lied.
Oh, shit. You're the new director. Hold on. We're coming out.
Director, Faden. Call me Jesse. Okay, Jesse. I'm Emily. Look, somehow, this hostile force, this...
Hiss?
That works? Somehow the Hiss managed to infiltrate the building without any warning.
And just like that, my name for it is official. The Hiss. Like the sound of poison gas leaking in.
We're in full lockdown. It seems to have spread everywhere and to everyone not protected by an HRA. And, extraordinarily, you. You are the director, and that makes you special by definition. Trench is no longer the director, obviously. I'm sorry, I'm talking too much. This whole situation is just a lot.
Trench is dead. Shot.
I found his body. And the gun.
Do I tell her it looked like a suicide?
The service weapon. Also, and this can sound crazy, he keeps appearing to me, saying things. It's hard to make out, but he told me to cleanse the control point, push the Hiss out. The whole room shifted around.
You did that? And you entered the building when it was already in the lockdown, before you became the new director? How?
I'm not ready to tell her about you yet.
A janitor let me in.
I love it. This is fucking unbelievable. I can't even... Look, Jesse, I have a million questions, and you probably have a million more.
Like, do you know my brother Dylan? Not yet.
But there's something I need to ask you to do first. If you can cleanse a control point, then you can maybe cure those infected or possessed by the Hiss. Because if that's possible, our options are very different.
Emily Pope. I don't know her, but I like her already. She's the opposite of the faceless agency I've blamed for what happened to me for so long. But I can't trust her yet. Or rather, the Bureau she's a part of.
Yes. I can try.
I'm speaking for you, of course. We can try it together. Okay. You with me? We did it before. Pushed the Hiss out.